Hello everybody, welcome to the Java course. It is easy to compare two primitives. For example, I just want to compare whether one is larger than two. If I want to do so, I can do something like this. And let me save it and run it. I will get false for the comparison of two integer primitives. But it is not that easy to compare two objects. For some built-in types, it is fortunate for us to use the compareTo method, which is given by some built-in classes like strings or integer objects. But how about some user-defined classes? If you want to compare two objects arising from a self-defined class, we have to use the compareTo interface. So this is the topic of this video. I want to make use of the compareTo method to compare two objects. So let us see some examples of the compareTo methods of built-in classes. What does it mean by that? Let us see some examples. Suppose I want to compare some strings. I have S1. S2 and S3. If I want to compare these three strings, it is quite sensible for us to follow the lexicographic order. That means we look up the dictionary and see whether S1 precedes S2 or something like that. In computer programming, when we want to compare two strings, the lexicographic order is like this. We also follow the A to Z pattern together with one more condition. We have to follow this condition, which is capital letters are smaller than small letters, in the sense that capital A precedes small letter A, something like this. So if we want to compare two strings, we can do some code in this way. The compareTo method given by the string class will give you an integer. If the integer returned by this method is larger than 0, it means that S1 is larger than S2. It also means that S1 is at the latter part of the lexicographical order. So let us see some result by running this command. False. That means S1 is not larger than S2. What does it mean by that? We can follow the lexicographic order. A, B, C, small, all are small letters. A, B, D here are all small letters. So when we want to compare whether S1 is smaller than S2, we have to check each of the letters accordingly. A to A, we can't compare. B to B, we can't compare. But C to D, we can compare. So C is smaller than D according to the lexicographic order. So we have to return the value false here, because S1 is actually smaller than S2 according to the lexicographic order. If S1 is smaller than S2, the return value of the compareTo method will be a negative number. So we can be sure that S1 is smaller than S2 if the result is false. And how about the other example? I want to check whether S1 is larger than S3. What do we get for this situation? Let us see. We will get true. Why? Because small letters are larger than capital two letters, according to the computer programming sense. So we will get a capital ABC being smaller than the small letters ABC. So the process is like this. Comparison process is like this. We check for the first pair which has different characters. So for comparing S1 against S2, we can check the letters accordingly. Oh, we can see that C and D are different. So we compare these two letters to see which one comes first according to the lexicographic order. And the capital letters are smaller than small letters. We have to follow these two conditions in order to compare two strings when we use the compareTo method given by the string class. And when we compare S1 and S3, we can see that the first letter is already different for S1 and S3. And capital A is smaller than small letter A, according to the computer programming sense. So S1 is actually larger than S3. We can get this result when we just compare the first character of each of the strings. If we want to compare two objects from a self-defined class, we have to use the comparable interface. So let us see an example. Suppose I have a class called bank account. ACC1. I have a constructor here to create an object having the bank account type, and ACC1 is a reference variable pointing to that object. I also have another reference variable pointing to another bank object, a bank account object. For account 1, I want to set the savings stored in that account. $20,000, for example. I also want to save $10,000 to account 2. So if we want to compare which account is having more savings, in principle, we can do something like this. We can also use the compareTo method, but this compareTo method is not the same as the one given from the string class. Actually, it is something given by the comparable interface. So let us see how I can do the compareTo method when I have a self-defined class. Suppose this is the idea of my bank account. I have an instance variable, which is a private one called savings. And then I have two methods. One is called setSavings, and the other is getSavings. If I want to use the compareTo method from the comparable interface, I just need something like this. I want to implement the comparable interface. Comparable angle bracket bank account. What does it mean by this syntax? I want to implement the comparable interface, and I want to compare two objects created from the bank account class. So I will use this syntax. Okay, comparable has one method for you to complete, which is the compareTo method. So when you want to implement comparable interface, you must settle the way to do the compareTo method. So we have to define compareTo method when we implement a comparable interface. So how can we set up the compareTo method? We can do something like this. The compareTo method given by the comparable interface is having a return type of integer. So this compareTo is quite similar to what we did for the string class. We would also have a number returned by the compareTo method when we compare two strings, and we want to see whether the value coming from that method is larger than 0, equal to 0, or smaller than 0. So for the compareTo method given by the comparable interface, it is also having a return type of an integer. We just want to compare the savings instance variable for a certain object to the savings amount for another object whose reference variable is ACC. So ACC is the formal parameter of the compareTo method, and this reference variable is pointing to an object having bank account type. If the savings is larger than the savings of another account, I would return 1. That means one account is larger than the other. And which one comes first and which one comes later, we will talk about it later. It is quite sensible to say that when the two savings accounts have the same amount, we will return 0. That means two accounts are having the same value as the deposited amount of money. If both conditions fail, we would return -1. That means one account is have less money than the other. So let us see how we can make use of this bank account to do the comparison of two bank account objects. When I call the compareTo method like this, this dot savings refers to ACC1, and ACC2 would be the actual parameter of the compareTo method. So it is sensible to say that account 1 is larger than account 2 according to this compareTo method. So we would expect that the value would be 1 for the compareTo method. Let us see the result. Save it and run it. Yes, I will get 1 as the answer from the compareTo method of the bank account class, because bank account 1 is saving more money than bank account 2, and according to the compareTo method defined for the bank account class, we would get 1. So this is the way we implement the compareTo method from the comparable interface. And after this video, I hope you're able to understand how we compare two objects. One for the built-in type and one for the user-defined type. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.